Shifter, you son of a bitch. Oh my god! Okay, that was like, that was ballsy to make a play like that. I didn't expect a flash hook. Ayo! No flash.
We must all make sacrifices. I hear a man likes a lady with legs. Come closer. I don't bite.
Spiz is good in tourney play. I can't judge that because I don't know many good Fizz players. It's like Tabs maybe? It's like, fuck. How many people even play Fizz? This Fizz is a different type of champion. It's like saying who's the best LeBlanc when there's like Faker. Like that's the only guy who plays it. See, I can camp mid or top. Shit, I'm gonna have to camp one of them because they're both playing really aggressive. This makes an interesting little scenario for me. If every lane plays aggressive, that means the team that has a better aggressive lane will win. Unless the jungle comes, that is where I come in. So I have to go aggressive on somebody, or I have to stop the aggression, because if everyone plays aggressive, they'll probably win without any interference from the jungle. Yeah, since he had no flash, we can easily flash Kakuna. Or lad. But if we can stall Kha'Zix's domination and make Fizz snowball, I won't have to gank that lane ever again because Fizz will be able to kill Kha'Zix without my help. That just leaves bot lane and top lane. Which, for some reason, we're losing both, huh? Hecarim just has to. No, I don't know. I think Hecarim's a dandy right now. He's like, I think Hecarim wants to go mid because that's the only lane of his not winning. Hecarim's mid. Wait, does it want me to tax? Fuck that. I got it. I got the big one. That's all that matters. Let's see. Fizz got ganked mid. I'm trying to figure out how to salvage this. Good shit by Fabi. Hecarim's bottom, trying to counter the aggression. Yeah. Alex the man, is he a Fabi? Let's see where it is. fuck. Mid might be the next gank for Hecarim, we'll see. Because when every lane's aggressive, that means jungler has to be aggressive. Because, or the lane will naturally lose. Curious to see if Kha'Zix is. Which one's all it's up. physics is flash. Oh, bugger off. I see what you're doing, you little shit.
Pull the strings. Watch them dance.
Like, dank in any lane almost guarantees the summoner will be used if everyone's playing aggressive. Because in aggressive land, it's much easier to get kills.
They need guidance.
See, I didn't have to do anything there. Oh fuck, the cocoon from... Ah, oh, fuck you, Dominant. Let's see. Kha'Zix's level 5, let's see where Spiz at. Fizz, she's 6. What the fuck happened to, let's see, Riven? Riven died. We should go Hex Drinker, that's what I'd do. Fuck, Fabi, please! If we had Fabi on Draven, I think results would be different. I have to go down here. That juicy CS. Riven better win mid, cause she lost top against Annie somehow. Cause all you have to do is just build a Hex Drinker and you beat Annie. Cause Annie's burst, like that basically takes away 1.5 spells of Annie if you get an early Hex Drinker. She can't do shit to that. Like Riven's shield, like Riven's E already takes away a spell. So then Annie's burst combo, which she relies on, has one last spell, and then if you have Hex Drinker, that reduces another spell and a half. So suddenly, if she can't ever use Tibbers basically, unless she uses several spells on Riven, but she can't make Riven's HP go down because Riven will just use shield for every spell. Fuck, Kekrom's top. Yeah, this is bad actually. I don't know. All my lanes for some reason lost. So I don't get what I did wrong. I think when you're in a promotion series, your lanes will just simply lose. It's up to you to figure a way to not have that happen. Like, this is like the last stage of a job interview. How do you make your lanes not lose? Like, I'm just playing follow now.
I can show them the way to divinity.
Oh what? Oh my god. What the fuck?
I know what looks in shadows.
I'm surprised the lantern was there. You should have got the lantern. Like, if you got the lantern here, that would have been actually a decent, really good play by Thresh. I didn't even know if Thresh went mid. I'm actually surprised. So I'm actually gonna go carry build. Like, I could go Aegis, but the way this game is going, I have to build this way. Like, normally I would not do this. Normally people actually go Ancient Golem on Elise, cause they nerfed this. They nerfed this, and then they made Ancient Golem look even better, cause they made Butcher better on Ancient Golem while not nerfing its stats, so. Right now, Ancient Golem is probably like the dominant thing. If you were in a tournament game, you'd probably get Ancient Golem. So, probably a 90% chance you'd probably build that one if you win a Spirit Stone item.
May run on two legs.
Hmm, I wonder if this is open. So I won't take much damage because at 730 is my because I have spiders, so my spiders will tank the damage, it looks like. Excellent. Yeah, it's pretty bad. So we get dragon, but I think we may lose that tower for it. Fuck, Fabi. And Alex the man! It's Alex. Oh my god. Like, Riven went mid and top. Oh wow, I'm sad. Because Riven was top and lost, and then goes mid and lost. So we lose two towers, that's actually bad. It's because our solo lanes are just losing. I'm not sure what happened. I thought I ganked enough, but it wasn't enough. I just noticed he sold his Lamanta too. Oh my god. So not only did he swap lanes, he actually bought an item that was for the Annie lane and he sold it. Wow, so we're in deep shit. Fucking Fabi is a god! Fabi is a legend. Pretty fucked though. Saying we should have backed off though, because I had a spree. Not worth. So I'm gonna go Rylas because they need some defenses. They have to keep going because their lanes are bottom. But I don't think those two would do that much damage to the tower. We'll see. Yeah, it's not exactly a fast push. Yeah, and she gets stomped like a Goomba. Like, our solo lane just got shit on really hard. And so I'm sort of sad about this promotion series. Oh, Ez hit me, okay. I assume my blue is dead. Yeah, it's dead. Hecarim and anywhere in the area. I don't know what I could really do better this game. I don't know, I figured that I snowballed mid and top, but they lost somehow. So it's like, whatever. So I don't think I'll win this promotion series, unfortunately. That's annoying. Nah, I'm 0-2 in my promo, so I lose the series, basically. Because they make the Challenger series harder, so... Like they, I don't know if they do it on purpose or maybe I'm just bad luck, but... At the end, they try to make it as hard as possible, so they give you a team you normally wouldn't have if you were not playing a series, because... The last three games, my lanes have always just lost for some strange reason, no matter what I do for them. Like, this game is weird, like... Again, mid, top, bottom, and they all lost. I don't understand how that's possible.
I know what lurks in the shadows.
Since this is too late. What the fuck? Oh, it's warded. That's warded. Yeah. They knew of her arrival. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Ugh. Fuck, I actually meant the cocoon, the person behind me, instead of repel. That early repel was bad by me. And our bot lane died too there. So, I'm the only one left.
I can show them the way to divinity. I know the true path.
Why, thank you.
I could be at Baron, what's there now? Not yet.
My true beauty is beneath the skin.
Like, anyone whining I stole kills? Like, do you even play this game? Look at their jungler. Their jungler has 7 kills too, and 1 assist. Like, I have 4 assists. Like, if you think me stealing kills decided them getting outplayed over and over? Like, let's watch this. Like, let's see how good this guy is. Oh my god, he might do it. Oh my god, he's a genius. No, never mind. See, like, nothing's gonna stop them from getting outplayed. They're just gonna get outplayed because they're not good at the game. Like, it doesn't matter if I gave them a billion kills. They're just gonna get outplayed. Like, Hecarim has 7 kills and now he has 2 assists. You don't see their team losing because he stole kills. No, he fucking got those kills. He earned those fucking kills. Like, the people that are saying, oh, you shouldn't steal kills like that. Like, you guys are probably fucking bronze or some shit. Like, that's why you're bronze, because you don't realize that the jungler needs farm too. Like, unless it's like a blatant obvious skill steal, like, don't bitch about it. Like, look at bot lane. Bot lane's dead again. Like, what am I supposed to do about that? Like, should I just give them all the kills and watch them lose with it? No, fuck no. That's not how you get the challenger. Challenger, you actually have to fucking do something. You can't just give everything away. Like, you can argue that I stole kills, but Hecarim has even more kills than me. His team's winning. That's basically how it is. Do you have this? No, I don't. Pretty good.
Watch them dance.
Alright, am I really gonna help our solo lanes? Like, if you look at our solo lanes, they're 2 and 12 together. Like, you really think that any amount of good would help them win? I honestly don't think so. Because they're just outclassed. Do you think those two kills, like, imagine if you didn't have 2 assists, imagine if you had 2 kills, do you really think the score would be any different? No. Like, I highly doubt it. Patience. Like, he has a whopping 2 assists. So that amounts to like 2 kills, whoopee doo.
Pull the strings.
Where's
Watch
Annie?
Them dance.
I found her. Wow. Yeah. We just don't have a team there. Well, they just have more people constantly. Time that. Yeah, Riven reset her gold counter, so now she's actually worth gold.
Show them the way to divinity. There is nothing to fear.
Fuck, I need follow-up, but I don't think we get it. I figured that since they only had 3 or 4 there, we could go on it, but we're just not as aggressive as we should be. Like, Annie's still not even there. I don't even know where Annie is. Annie's like bot lane and we lost. Like, there you go. Like, no one follows up, so it's like whatever. I'm gonna run top again with home guard this time. Draven's pretty fucked, yeah.
I know the true path has been destroyed. Everywhere a masterpiece.
Fuck, I couldn't stun him because there's minions in the way. And the reason why I went a different build is, like, early game we're just getting stomped, so the only way I could possibly salvage this is to do damage, but I don't think it's enough. Because now we're not going to have a tank. Like, Blitz is our tank now, and Blitz is a support. You can't really build tanky that well with no gold. Like, right now he has less HP than he has. 400 less HP than me, basically. So, like, our late game prospect is very little. Because Fizz isn't very good late game. Riven's not very good late game, I don't think. Draven's not as good. I guess he could be better, slightly better than Ezreal in some cases, late game, but I'm certainly not better late game than Hecarim. So, like, tanks are superior than melee casters. Unless it's like OP Kha'Zix or Zed. Because a lot of melee casters aren't so useful later. Because if you can survive a combo, the melee caster is probably in range to get killed instantly. My Oh shit, it's Draven. But it's our Draven. I was like, what? Think they're hiding in a brush somewhere, maybe? I'm just waiting for the next person to come here. If many people come here, I lose. Simple as that. If only one person comes, well, that happens. Shit, can I beat a fed Kha'Zix at this moment? Oh shit. Well, if we work as a team, maybe. What the fuck? We just do no damage. Where's Riven? What the fuck? I thought we'd win that because they only had 3 left. Fuck. Like Riven was actually walking bottom and all that. Fuck. But yeah, they do a lot of damage. Who killed me? It was Ez, yeah. Ez is pretty fed too. All of them were pretty fed. My chat's like dead. My chat is dead, dude. My chat hasn't moved in like 10 minutes. Maybe my flash failed me. Baron will be in 20 seconds. Yeah, I think my chat died. Because no one's talking, so I'm just gonna refresh it.
I can show them the way to divinity. I know what lurks in the shadows.
Wait, what? Oh fuck, I have no vision. God, it wasn't me, because I know I didn't get the direct Baron. I think they made a mistake of killing it while Hecarim jumped over. Hecarim couldn't smite it, I couldn't smite it, we're both on the wrong side. I think Fizz got it, it looks like, because Fizz does a lot of damage with his autos. Oh, Fabi, please! The gatekeeper! Gatekeeper. Gatekeeper, open the gate. Okay, we gotta hold our base together, though. Can we win a Baron throw? How strong is a Baron throw? It depends on our late game. I don't think our late game is much better. Like, it's hard to. Like, diving Ezreal is harder than diving Draven. Like, if they had Draven, I'd say we have a good shot because Fizz and Riven can insta give him. But Ezreal, if he has. Ezreal has Flash, it's very easy for him to get away from Riven, Fizz. He just Arcane shifts and then follow it up with. Got all the flash.
shadows.
Let's do it again soon. Shadow, you know, I'm running here. I'm just getting home guard.
We must all make sacrifices.
We have enough sufficient clearance. Question is, oh god, it's a trap. It's a fucking trap. Don't do it. Fuck. What are you clowns doing? Oh, I'm surprised I got owned so hard by Ezreal. My music's dead too, what the fuck? And my chat's not working. What the fuck? It's fucking Thresh. 20 seconds did he do damage on inhibitor tower. I was good by Fizz. Fizz took away the... basically wiped out the HP of... what was it? Kha'Zix, and then it made Ezreal wide open. Shit, this is bad. Fuck, this is not good. I didn't plan this. Wow, I'm dead, dude. Fuck! I should have backed off. I was dumb and I tried to hit this. Which is dumb. Fuck. Alright, my bad. This might be my fault. Because they're just through. Really bad play by me. We can defend the tower, we just can't defend inhibitor. Fuck, unless he gets a hero hook. Oh no, he shouldn't have done that. That was bad, that was very bad. Cause now it's more likely for them to get, but there's like no way to fight even if I do come up. Yeah, that's bad. I don't know how long Fizz ult is. They are split, I'm not sure why. We need to defend those. Okay, there you go, the chat's back. Shit is alive. All I can do is like build Rand Runes or something, man. It's either War Mods or Rand Runes right now. There's no point building any more offense. Because you saw I couldn't even beat Ezreal that fight, because I guess he did more damage than me. Like, he did jump away and get away, but... I don't think I'd be able to beat Ezreal alone. Oh fuck. Wow, I'm sad. I should have got that. If I hit that cocoon, he would have died. That's annoying. It's annoying again. It's also annoying. I gained 200 HP by smite at this HP.
every well a masterpiece. They need guidance.
500 damage on the Q, not bad. If Hecarim was there, he could have got it. Because it went down to like 500. Anyone can smite that.
Pull the strings. Watch them dance.
What am I close to? It's either that or
Randuin's. My poison.
I think I might go Randuin's, yeah. Wormhouse doesn't seem so good when I have no armor and MR. That's the problem with Elise. Her base armor is trash for a melee. Because they nerfed it because they took away the spider form. Wow. Bankai. Riven can actually one-shot most of them. Yeah, she's the bait. Pretty sure somewhere amongst the left side is more people. He assumed the same thing, yeah. Not sure if we need the axe though. Pretty sure. I think we could, yeah, do it all in mid. Babby, you almost saved the game. Saved Christmas. Once the inhibitors are up, oh fuck. We'll be able to.
Dangling by a thread. There's nothing to fear.
Fucking Fabi is a god.
I have refined.
That was a good hook. It forces Hecarimot out.
My true beauty is beneath.
This will be my final item. I need something to duel Ezreal and Kha'Zix with. I can't duel them with no armor. They'll just shit on me first. Like if you go full glass cannon and they're a champion better suited for that, like Kha'Zix with Cleaver, Last Whisper, you will lose. So Randuin's is my only hope. I have a chance at surviving a duel with them. That's nine. Oh fuck. Fuck, I think people dove when they didn't get a kill. Yeah. Shit. Yeah, I think they all chased Ezreal and they didn't manage to get him. Yeah, I think that's GG. Because as soon as Kha'Zix jumped in, everyone should have just jumped on him. Because he's the easiest target, like he's right in front of Draven. I think we lose, yeah. Because they have Thresh, Annie, all covering Ezreal. They didn't have anyone covering Kha'Zix because Kha'Zix jumped in. So yeah, so you should never dive in. Like, later game you should probably... Like, unless your team is specifically a dive comp, which ours isn't, because they're just too strong right now, they have Thresh. Yeah, it's usually hit the closest target. That's usually a common strat in tourney play, at least. And so, like, you should. I mean, ideally, you'd hit the closest target, but... Because they were hitting the closest target, because the closest target walked up to them.